back again today, make another video, and this one should be good. Me and my buddy, we took off work a few days, and I woke up at 2:30 this morning, drove all the way down to a new management area. It took me about 3 hours to get down here, and we're staying. Today's Thursday, so we're gonna stay till Sunday. We might hunt Sunday morning before we go home, depending on what happens this weekend. But it's a gun hunt from Thursday till Sunday. So, and I ain't never been here before. He's been here a few times, so he's gonna come this afternoon. And I showed up this morning so I can hunt this morning. Just a spot I found that looked good on the map, and then I was gonna scout about middle of the day and then hunt the afternoon too. So, but yeah, it's 5:40 right now, so just got done eating. Guess I'm about to get my stuff together and start walking in. So hope this is a good one. I don't know if it's gonna be one big video or a bunch of two or three parts to it per day, but anyway, I hope y'all enjoy and y'all stay tuned for this upcoming few hunts we gonna have. So, but yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and walk in, so I'll catch you in the tree. All right, guys, so we just been up here for a little while. It got daylight now, and it's about 7 o'clock now. It looks pretty good in here. We got a super thick stuff on both sides of me. And then down in this creek bottom, it's still pretty thick, but it's a little bit more open. I can get a shot. So we're gonna sit here for a while, probably till about lunch. I ate breakfast, so I should be good until lunch. And then we're gonna go out and scout, look around, look for some new spots. Yeah, it took me a little bit to get in here. This is some different cover than what I'm used to back home. Everything's thick. Yeah, but we should see something in here. I've seen two or three rubs on the way in. They're in pre-rut down here right now, so maybe some of them will be on their feet moving here in a little bit when the sun comes out, but catch y'all if we see something in this spot, so we'll catch you then. Alright, guys, so it's about 9:30, and I was just sitting here, and there's a cutover to my right, about 400 yards, something like that, over there, and there was this guy blasting all morning. He shot 3 times, I heard 7 shots total by 8:20, and it's 9:30 now, and he shot again. So that'd be number four. But not about as I was packing up, I was gonna pack up, get down, and walk around, try and find some more spots, because I ain't seen nothing and everybody else has been shooting. So I thought maybe I was in a bad spot. While I'm sitting there, I've already took my big camera down and everything, and I'm wrapping up the rope that holds it on the tree, and I look over, and there's every bit of 30 deer running by, one after another after another. It was all does, and there might have been one spike in there, I think I seen a spike. And it was just deer after deer after deer. So I grabbed my rifle and turned the dash cam on, but nothing come out to shoot. And two does stuck around while the other ones went up that hill, and I parked at the top of that hill. But there was just deer after deer, and I couldn't get much of nothing on camera because I had stuff in my hand and stuff laying in my lap trying to get it all in the bag. And I finally got my camera out. I think I got a glimpse of one of them, the last one, and I tried to video with my other camera, my little camera, some. It don't have much zoom on it though, so maybe I caught something to show y'all. But about 30 deer, at least. They just kept running by. I guess they was running away from that guy shooting every deer in the county over there in that cutover. But, I'm going to get down here. I guess I'm going to sit a little bit longer now. And I'm going to get down, walk around, try and find some sign in here. Maybe not in here. I might walk out and go to some different spots. I don't know yet. But, y'all stay tuned for this video because it's going to be good. But anyway, I'll catch y'all whenever something else walks out or whenever I get down. So we'll see you then. Alright guys, I just got that little buck on video. He's right in front of me right now. I was just walking around and I look up, my deer is walking away. It's a six or seven point. It's a little small though. I'm gonna let him walk. And it's only the first day too, so. It was a smaller buck. But he's somewhere right here. He didn't even know I was here. So that's 30 does and a lot of does and a spike and a little 5 or 6 pointer. I hope I got him on the tacticam, because I raised my gun up and turned the tacticam on, just in case it was a big buck. I seen horns and put it on him, and then saw they wasn't that big, so I just kept pointing it at him, watching him go by. But I'm gonna keep on walking and looking for some sign. Hopefully I don't bump that deer. But y'all stay tuned. That was crazy. If it was a big one, I could have shot him. I snuck right up on him. But yeah, I'm gonna walk around some more, see if I can't see nothing else. Alright guys, I'm headed back now. I didn't really see nothing else. It's hard to tell if they're in full pre-rut or not. Cause I seen a rubber this morning when I was walking in, but it was dark, so I don't know. I'll have to go back and look at it on my way out. I don't know if it was from this year or last year. But that buck looked like he was smelling for does. When he was walking, he kept doing that with his head up and down. But, I'm headed out of here. Go check out some more spots and probably eat me something. I'm getting pretty hungry now. find that tree I was in to get my bag. It was somewhere around here. But yeah, whenever I get back to the truck, I'll catch y'all. Catch y'all then. There it is. Yeah, I'll catch y'all then. So we'll see. Hi guys, we're back in the truck now. My buddy got here and we was riding around looking at this new cutover they cut last year. And we was just sitting there just looking, and all of a sudden a big old buck stood up and ran away out of the cutover. It was a big one. I glassed him right as he was run off the property and on the private, so we gonna back out of here and go up the top of the hill. We might come back and hunt this spot, but it was a pretty good one. But we're gonna keep looking, see if we can't see nothing else. All right guys, just made it to the second spot of the day here in the afternoon, and we're gonna hunt till dark. My buddy's over there across over that hill, and probably 300, 400 yards that way. This creek bed runs down in here, goes that way, and comes back around, goes that way and loops around, and he just followed it around. And then it keeps going that way, kind of like a Y, and then it goes that way onto private property. But yeah, we're gonna sit here, till dark and see what we can do. So I'll get y'all out when something happens, so y'all stay tuned. Alright guys, we've been out here for a little while. It's 3 o'clock right now. That doe come behind me about an hour ago. I didn't even hear her. I just happened to look back and I saw her, and she was about right there. And we ain't seen nothing else, but maybe something else will come through. Before dark, we got about an hour and a half till dark. So we're gonna sit here and wait. This looks like a pretty good spot. Got a bunch of fingers coming down at each of the creek bottoms. And then it Y's together over there. So if they were coming this way from the big creek bottom, and they got two chances, either right or left, and we're sitting on either one, so they're gonna be dead either way. I think there's another deer up here I just heard moving around in front of me. It might have been a stick fell out of the tree. But yeah, we're gonna sit here and wait, see what happens. And there's been a few people shooting here and there. I think I heard 7 shots this morning and 2 or 3 this afternoon, so we'll see. They're moving pretty good today though. It's been real rainy and hot for like the past 2 weeks, and it's finally sunny out and drier, and it's cold today. That wind's blowing hard. Maybe something will come out, so I'll catch you then. All right guys, welcome back. It's day 2, and we're gonna hunt this cutover. we seen that big buck in yesterday, so it's 5:50 right now. The sun comes up at 6:50, so I'm gonna go ahead and start heading in there. Hopefully I'll be set up about 6:20 is what I'm planning on, because it'll start to get to where you can see start to about 6:20, so I'm gonna go ahead and start walking in. But yeah, we both hunting this cutover, so maybe one of us will see that big one or a different one. So yeah, y'all stay tuned. I'm gonna go ahead and walk in, and we'll catch you in the tree. All right, guys, it's about 7:30, and we've been set up since dark. Horton didn't make it all the way down to where he was going, and I didn't either. We ain't never been in here. We drove up from the road way over there yesterday, but we never did really come down in here to see where we was gonna set up. But I think I'm in a pretty decent spot, and he's down there close to where that buck was yesterday. So I hope we see something, maybe something to walk out. When I was coming down at dark, coming in, I spooked something sitting in these group of trees right here, and whatever it was didn't go too far. It jumped two or three times and then stopped. So maybe it just walked down in this bottom right here. Maybe it'll come out here in a little bit. I think they're gonna move probably about 8 to 10 o'clock, because yesterday I didn't see them deer till 9 or 9:30. So maybe they'll get on their feet here in a little while once the sun starts coming down on the bottom where they're at. Maybe we'll see a few deer too. So stay tuned, and I'll pick y'all back up whenever we see something. Guys, it's 8:30. The sun's up and shining in these bottoms, and I can start to see gaps in the bottoms to where if one does walk through the bottom of it, I'll be able to hopefully get a shot on one. But I ain't seen nothing yet, and the sun's out, so Hopefully we should see something here in a minute. But I don't know if they're gonna move or not this morning. I don't know. Hopefully they will though, so I'll check back in with you whenever we see something. We're gonna get down about 10 o'clock. I don't know where we're gonna go this afternoon. We might go to that bottom that I sat in first day where I seen all them deer, and I don't know. I'll probably shoot that buck if I see him again. I let him slide the first time. I don't know, but yeah, I'll catch back with you whenever we see something. So I'll see you then. There's that bottom right there. I can get a few gaps in it every now and again, right there and right there, and I can see to the other side. And there's another one down there. I can't see in this one yet. The sun's still shining in my face, and it ain't hit it yet. But yeah, maybe something will walk out. And then that's up here is where I spooked that deer this morning. He was kind of up in there, and I can see all that too. So maybe we'll see something here in a minute. So I'll catch back up with you. Catch up with you then. I'm in a new spot now. I went and see nothing this morning, and we're hunting this big bottom. It's attached to the first bottom that I hunted on the first morning that I got here. I seen all them deer, and I walk to the edge now. I'm about to drop off in it, and a doe just got up and ran to the left. That's the way that I was hunting, to the left. And this bottom's wide open down in here, so I just stopped right here and kind of sat down. I'm gonna give it a minute for that doe to chill out. She ran down here and stopped. I think she's walking around. I'm gonna give her a minute to go away. And I'm gonna have to get in here pretty quick and get set up so I don't spook nothing else. But yeah, it should be a good hunt down in here. It's wide open. I should be able to see a lot. And then Horton's on the other side, on this other bottom, so we should see something. We've already seen something, but Horton's gonna shoot a doe if he gets a chance. And I'm just gonna hunt for a buck, so. Maybe one of us will shoot one this afternoon, so y'all stay tuned. I've been set up for about 10 minutes. It's a real good spot. It's wide open. And I'm facing to where that doe was. There's a cut over in front of me. And then another one over here behind me. So, and then the rest of it to my right is them woods. And I probably hunted 600 or 700 yards that way. When I seen all them does and that buck and the spike. That first morning. So this is the good area. And I seen some old rubs. I seen another one that I didn't get on video over here by the creek, and it was on a big tree. So there was a big one in here, so maybe he's still around. Maybe he'll come walking through in Horton's that way somewhere. I don't know how far he went, but maybe we'll see a few this afternoon. Maybe get a shot on a buck or a doe. So y'all stay tuned. I think this is gonna be a real good spot. So we're gonna sit here and wait. So I'll catch you whenever something happens. too much yesterday afternoon. I didn't end up seeing anything else besides that doe that I spooked in. And the game warden was waiting for us. When we come out, he just check our license and stuff. But we out at a new spot this morning, hunting a power line. So we gonna sit here and wait. We seen a doe cross the power line the other day when we was driving. So we gonna sit on it, see if we can't see something. So yeah, we just gonna sit and wait. Maybe something will come out. So I'll catch you whenever something happens. Alright guys, been out for a little while at the other spot. I didn't see anything, and Horton seen two does, but they crossed on private property. It was a little too far away down the power line. And we come in here to this spot I'm in right now. Looked around some, and there's a fresh rub and scrape about 50 yards across the bottom over there, but it's just too thick in here for me to climb a tree, so I'm just gonna sit on the ground for the rest of the afternoon. It's about 1 o'clock right now, so we're gonna sit here till dark, and then Horton went up somewhere else to hunt. I think he's gonna sit on a green field, but yeah, we're just gonna sit and wait. I think there's a pretty good buck in here, what it looks like. Pretty nice rub on one of the trees. Looks real good in here. It's kind of open but thick at the same time. It'd be rough to sit in a tree in here. It'd be easier to hunt on the ground. Maybe we'll see something, so I'll get you back out whenever something happens.
Alright guys, it's the next day, and me and Horton just decided to come home. It was pretty rough hunting. After that first day we seen a bunch of deer, seen that one in the middle of the day, that big buck, and then I seen the doe that afternoon, and then I didn't see nothing else the rest of the trip. Hunting, I think I might have seen a spike, and I spooked a doe walking in one afternoon, and then Horton seen them two does cross on the power line, but it was on public land, a little too far away. But it was fun. At least we got to go down there and find some more spots. We're gonna go back and when it's the rut down there, so we'll be back down there here in a few weeks. So we got some good experience in and some good scouting too. So anyway, so thank y'all for watching this video, and like and subscribe if you ain't already, and go check out our Instagram. We got some more content down in there. I'll leave it in the description, but y'all stay tuned for some more videos coming out. We got a bunch more in the process and some in the future, but yeah, so we'll catch you on the next one. Like, subscribe, and we'll see you later.